Hello, and welcome to the March 2016 edition of Radnor 411. My name is Jim Doling, and I'll be your host. Our first segment this month is with the Community Development Department, where Marianne Cassidy tells us about outdoor dining regulations. Marianne?
Hi, my name's Marianne Cassidy. I work in the Community Development Department along with the Health Officer Larry Taltone. With the outdoor dining season upon us, I wanted to make sure that you're aware that animals are not allowed on the premises of the food establishments. There are a few exceptions, which are the patrol dogs accompanying police and security officers, and they're allowed in the offices, dining, sales, and storage areas. Service animals are allowed in dining and sales areas and be controlled by the disabled employee or person as long as the health or safety hazard will not result in the presence of the activities of the service animal. Institutional care facilities such as nursing homes, assisted living facilities, group homes, or residential health care facilities at the time other than during meals with certain sanitary conditions which are effective, partitions must separate the common area from the food preparation and storage areas. Condiments must be stored in an enclosed cabinet or removed from the common area where the pets are present. And the dining areas include tables, countertops, similar surfaces are to be cleaned before the next meal service. Thank you.
Our next segment is with the Public Works Department and Paul Bezik. Paul?
Hi, I'm Paul Bezik. I'm Superintendent of Operations at Public Works, and I'm here to talk to you about the screen mulch and tub grindings that is going out to some of the parks in the township. And it's there for your convenience. It's leaves that were picked up, recycled, and we run it through the screener, and that's what makes your mulch. And I just want to give you the locations of these parks that you could pick up your tub grindings and screen mulch at. Skunk Hollow, which is off of Darby Paley Road. There's tub grindings there and there's screen mulch. The Willows Cottage off of Darby Paley Road, which everybody knows about the Willows. They just have mulch down there. Philippone Park, there is mulch there. That's off of South Devon Avenue. Harford Park, we have tub grindings and we have mulch. And that is off of Gulf Creek. And we have Fenimore Park. We have mulch there. It's off of Shimoni Road, Paul Road, Eagle. It's the big park there. Has the big pavilion. You can pick up mulch there as well. Emlyn Tunnel Park. There's tub grindings there and mulch. It's off of Garrett Avenue. And then we have Ithan Valley Park. There's tub grindings there. And there's screened mulch there as well. It's off of Ithan Avenue by Roberts Road. So take advantage of this and mix it in with your garden, your topsoil. It's a big help. It'll help things grow. A little acidy, so add some lime to it. I believe that helps it out. So enjoy it. It's free. Compliments of Radnor Township. Your tax dollars are at work. Thank you very much.
And now we hear from the Recreation and Community Programming Department, where Director Tammy Cohen tells us about some of the wonderful programs the Township has to offer you. Tammy?
Hi, everybody. My name's Tammy Cohen. I'm the Director of Recreation and Community Programming. I'm here to talk to you about some of the upcoming activities and things that are going on with the Recreation Department for February 2016. We're gearing up for another busy month. Of course, we have a lot of really great things going on, a lot of great programming, a lot of great events that are getting ready to take off here in the early spring months. And we also have a lot of really great park projects that are being worked on. If you get the opportunity and you want to read more about those, you can go to the Recreation Department's website and then from there link over to the park projects. And if you ever have any questions about some of the projects that are going on, don't hesitate to give us a call. One of the biggest, of course, that we have that's going to be taking place here shortly is a park renovation project at Clemichrome Park, one of our busiest parks and busiest neighborhoods in all of the township. The park's not going to look the same when it's done. We've got a lot of really great recreational amenities that are going to be improved there, including the entire footprint of the park. So if you have a chance, be sure to check that one out online. And feel free to call our offices if you have any questions, and we can make sure you get all the information that you're looking for. We also have a very busy programming time right now within the department. The Radnor Youth Basketball Program is up and running. We've got around 200 volunteers that make that program possible, and I want to take an opportunity to thank all of those individuals. Without them, the program certainly wouldn't have the backbone of success that it does have. So we appreciate all of their hard work and efforts, all of the time, the efforts, the energy, and of course the basketball expertise that they bring to the program. We also want to take an opportunity to thank Dave McGrath and Jumpstart Sports, who's our partner in the delivery of the program. All those individuals help us with our success in delivering a safe and quality program for the residents of Radnor Township. In addition, working with all of the schools here locally, the private schools and Radnor Township School District is a great and wonderful thing that we have with such good relationships, and I want to thank all those schools for working with us for allowing the program to take place in their schools. There's a number of other activities that are up and running. The Winter and Spring 2016 Activities Brochure has been published. You can find it at our program website, right at www.radnor.com/recreation. If you want to give our department a call too, we can definitely send that document out to you. You can reach us at 610-688-5600. You can ask for anyone in the recreation department, and we'll be happy to send that out to you. So there's a plethora of activities that are available for youth, adults, just for everyone, a lot of different things that are going on. If you have any program questions or you have any programs that you would desire to see, you can definitely reach out to us as well and let us know more about those. Switching gears, lastly, of course, into our community events, which, you know, given that the spring months are going to be here upon us shortly, I want to take an opportunity to talk about two really big events that are going to be going on. The first one is the Spring Extravaganza and Community Celebration, which takes place on Sunday, March 13th. It has a rain date of March 20th from 2 o'clock to 5 o'clock p.m. And it is at Villanova Stadium, right there in the big stadium at Villanova University. And it's a great celebration, great event. You'll see opportunities to meet with the Easter Bunny, some of the local fire companies, a lot of local businesses and organizations. And of course, the event, you know, wouldn't be what it is without the Easter egg hunts and of course a visit by the Easter Bunny. The egg hunts are tremendous. There's a lot of really great prizes, a lot of exciting things like bikes and gift cards. So not just treats and trinkets, but a lot of really special items as well. And the egg hunts are for all ages. So not only are they for children and youth, but they're also for adults. So it's a really good time. If you want to take an opportunity here to watch a little bit more about last year's event, we have a presentation that you can watch that will take you through what happened at that event last year in 2015. This spring, we also have the Wheels of Wayne, which is an annual event that's been taking place here in Radnor for many years. The Wheels of Wayne is a car show event. It takes place in downtown Wayne, right on North Wayne Avenue and part of West Avenue, which cuts off of North Wayne Avenue. The event will take place on Sunday, April 24th, and has a rain date of Sunday, May 1st. The event does run all day from 1 o'clock to 4 o'clock p.m. It's a great day for families to get out, enjoy the sunshine. The event's not just about the cars and all the vehicles, but there's lots of live entertainment. There's a barbecue contest, a pulled pork barbecue contest, a pizza contest, so there's a lot of really great foods to eat, lots of great vendors, a lot of great opportunities for entertainment and activities for kids. So it is a very family friendly fun activity and event. Again, you know, takes place on North Wayne Avenue, and just a great event all around. Definitely is one that you want to get out to. To take an opportunity to view last year's event, 2015 event, we have this presentation here for you to take a look at and enjoy. And as with any of our community events, please don't hesitate to reach out to us. Spring is also very busy with the Arbor Day celebration and, of course, the annual Trout Derby. So you can definitely log on to our website and read more about those, as well as the Spring Extravaganza and the Wheels of Wayne event. My name's Tammy Cohen. Thanks again for joining us for this February edition of Radnor 411, and we'll see you in March.
Our last segment this month is with the Finance Department.
Hi, good afternoon. My name is Bob Tate. I'm the Assistant Finance Director here at Radnor Township. I also serve as the HR Manager. But what I want to talk to you today about is in my role as the Assistant Finance Director, I'm the Business Tax Administrator. Here in Radnor Township, we have a business privilege tax and a mercantile tax. It's been on the books for some 30 plus years. It's a tax paid by all businesses in the township. It is assessed to those who are domiciled here and operate in the township. And it's basically a straight up tax on gross receipts. We've had a lot of support from our CARFAC committee in analyzing the process, how we administer the tax, how we work with the businesses. Our goal has always been and continues to be business friendly, supportive, and helpful, and even encouraging to the business community to work with them and assist in any way that we can. We're here Monday through Friday, 8 to 4 o'clock, available at any time, a phone call, an email, stop in. I'll be more than happy to help with any questions, concerns, or even the process of filling out business tax forms and filing. The business taxes are on a calendar year basis, January through December, with the tax forms due May 15th the following year. Our CARFAC committee has been incredibly helpful and recently heard some concerns expressed by some of the businesses here in our community. And we held a meeting, special meeting, with our CARFAC committee, a healthy representation from members of the Board of Commissioners, and a handful of businesses who just want to come out and talk about some of their concerns, some of their fears, some of their what they don't know about the process, and wanted to see how the township could help. At the end, I think it was a very productive and very fruitful meeting. We are here to assist and work with our taxpayers, and the goal from day one has been just uniformity in compliance across the board. A couple years ago, we heard from taxpayers who were telling us that they know of people who don't file. We've made every effort to identify businesses who are operating here and who just either don't file, whether they are unaware of the tax, or unfortunately in some cases they choose to ignore the regulations. At the recommendation of our CARFAC committee, we engaged a third-party firm who does assist in helping to do the discovery work, finding people and businesses in the township who are operating but have either failed or forgotten to register, or they have failed or forgotten to file taxes. So it begins there on the front end. Our administrative staff here, we work with our taxpayers, we process their returns, we communicate when there are deficiencies and problems. And we do have a very seasoned auditing and legal enforcement team to help when needed. And I say that because it's only when needed. When we talk about our audit process, I have to stress there is nothing random about auditing. We review every tax return. We review taxpayers. And when we find indications of noncompliance, deficiency in filing, for a specific reason, we would then put them on a list of a potential audit. So again, it's really in order to gain compliance across the board, so that everyone who is subject to the tax, that everyone pays their fair share, and there's no unequal burden or unfair burden placed on some who choose to comply and those who choose not to. So we're now right in the midst of our season, so to speak. Tax returns are now just beginning to filter in. They're being processed. They will be examined. They'll be reviewed. And there's always the ongoing compliance effort, which is, like I said, it's very involved. We're very engaged. And we're here to help. We have found taxpayers who maybe didn't file for a long time, maybe they were filing incorrectly, and they were facing some significant assessments. We work with them. We offer payment plans. We offer methods to bring people into compliance without overburdening anyone in particular. So that's a quick snapshot of our Act 511 business taxes. If you have any questions, concerns, issues, we're here. I did say Monday through Friday, 8 to 4, but if there's a community meeting, a business meeting, business association meeting that occurs maybe early morning or after hours, and there are a group of you who want to know more about the business taxes, simply let me know. I'll be happy to make myself available and come out and talk to the business leaders of this great community. And just simply help everyone to understand and make sure that everyone is in compliance for what part of the tax applies to them. Thank you very much. Have a great day.
Well, there you have it. Thanks for watching Radnor 411. Please stay tuned next month for a brand new episode. And remember, RTV is your information station.
We weren't born.